Good morning, YouTubers. It's a brisk 39 degrees out on a Friday morning. And I'm going to do a quick tutorial today on this little gauge in your automobile that I like to refer to as the gas gauge or the fuel gauge. Now, the reason I'm going to do this is there's some people in my life that apparently don't understand the function or purpose of this gauge. They just don't realize what it does and why it's there. So I'm going to explain it in terms that hopefully they will understand so that they will never, ever again get into a pickle and run out of fuel. So here we go. So you can see it's got this little diagram of what I like to call a gas pump. You can see there's this machine with a hose and a nozzle, and it's pointing to this letter F. Now, this letter F does not mean finished, it means full. Okay? Full. So, what I mean by that is, let's hypothetically say this is a 20-gallon tank. Full would mean that there's 20 gallons of gasoline in your tank. That means if you get 10 miles of the gallon, you can go 200 miles. Now, the next little click right here is the 3/4 mark, or 3/4. So let's, in terms that they will understand, divide your tank into 4 equal parts. This means that 3 of those parts are filled with fuel and 1 is not. So that would mean, in a 20-gallon tank, that you have 15 gallons of fuel remaining, or 150 miles. Again, if you're in a truck like mine, getting only 10 miles of the gallon. So, the next click, this white line, you can see how it's differently colored? That's because that's the halfway mark. That means we're down to 10 gallons. Now again, if we divide the tank into 4 equal parts, that means there's only two of those cells that are filled. So now we're down to 10 gallons or 100 miles. And I should have relayed what this little dial means. That dial, that's going to point to how much fuel you have left. So you can see that I'm just a tad above a half a tank. So telling me that I got just over 10 gallons left, maybe 11. So then we're going to go down here. That's the 1/4 mark. That means one of my 4 cells has fuel. So now I'm down to 5 gallons or 50 miles. Wow, that's not very much. I should probably fill up at this point, right? Oh no. Now we got this little click here. Oh, that's an 1/8 of a tank. Now we're really getting low, because now we only have 2.5 gallons left in our car. One would think that, holy crap, I'm there. I should probably fill up, right? Oh God, no, right? We're gonna go by that little gauge, you know, that they click through on their car that says, oh, you have 20 miles till empty, or you have 10 miles till empty, and then, oh, I can make it to a gas station. Well, until you get to the point to where, oh, look at that, it's closed, or the ramp is shut down and I can't make it off the freeway. Ah! Now we get to the most vital part, this last line. That's empty. See the E there? Empty. Not enough. It's empty. So at that point, you're pretty much screwed. And if you're lucky, you might be able to coast into a gas station. Hopefully you didn't do any damage to your fuel pump, because as anybody with any mechanical knowledge knows, that with the new gas pumps being in the gas tank, they're kind of cooled by the fuel. So hopefully you didn't screw it up too bad and run it dry, but you know, that's life. So hopefully this will explain to you, you know, what each of these little lines means and what you should do. Like me, I like to play it safe, and anywhere between a half and a quarter there, that's where I like to fill up. Or if I see a good deal at a gas station, I might top her off just to play it safe. But again, people, full, empty. Have a good day.